We're here on Father's Day at the Open Grove Range in California. We're here with Gary Eliseo, inventor and creator of the Eliseo tube guns, and Mark Lefevers, who has started with a tube gun kit and modified it. Mark, tell us about your creation.
Sure. Well, this is Gary's RTS kit for the Remington 700 Action and clones. This has a Jim Borden action in it, really smooth. I love the action, I love the stock. I've added a wood pistol grip in place of the AR style grip and changed the butt pad just a little bit here to add a sorbethane recoil pad. A little less, since I shoot out of a t-shirt a lot, a little less irritating on the shoulder. This has a Krieger 30-inch 12.5 to 1 twist barrel, medium Palma contour. And I added a muzzle brake to the end to damp the recoil just a little bit more. Shooting at silhouette steel targets, it's nice to be able to maintain your sight picture when you hit steel and see the target go down. And this is a bipod that I've added. My design, a fast attach mechanism, cam mechanism, simple lever to clamp onto the rails that Gary provides on his stock. Just a fast attach, drop and clamp and go. Aluminum, still a little bit heavy, but works well, very stable. A little different feet than the rubber feet I don't care for. They don't grip very well on pads. The serrated feet get a good bite, and you can shoulder hard into the bipod without it shifting.
Gary, I know when you build these things, you imagine they'd be used by high power shooters, cross the course shooters, but Mark has been using this gun in a variety of disciplines, including bench rest. What do you think of that?
You know, the RTS was originally designed sort of as a tactical platform, but there is a target version for across the course shooting and so forth, and prone shooting. But when I originally designed it, any of my systems, they really weren't thought of as bench rest, because I'm really not a bench rest shooter. But we've had good results. I've sold a number of them to bench rest shooters, mid-range and long-range bench rest mostly. And they've had some pretty good success in the past with it. So it's one thing about the tube gun design in general is it's highly adaptable. It's easy to make it do a lot of things well.
Gary, the tube gun and various kinds of space guns have really taken over in across the course competition. What are the two or three big advantages of a tube gun when shooting across the course?
Well, I'd say it's got excellent adjustability. You can adjust it to just about any position you want. You really can. You can the tubular handguard is very comfortable when you're in a sling. You don't have the square forends of the older rifles tend to be kind of uncomfortable. But probably the biggest feature is the way the bolt rides under your face when you're on the gun. So you can maintain your sight picture while you're operating the bolt. You don't have to lift your face away while you're cycling the bolt. And that's really is a big feature. Because that gets you operating the gun almost like you would a gas gun. You can stay on the sights through your rapid strings, and to me that's a very important feature. The cartridges you can get in them, you know, they work with all the stuff that people are using now, the 6BR, 6XC, 6.5 Lapua, 6.5/47 Lapua, 6.5 Creedmoor, all of which are very popular now in over the course shooting.
That looked good too.
But you could do that.
I look pretty good.
Yeah.
Those are all going in the same hole too.
Well, that
same hole.
There you go.
Hi, I'm Mark Lefevers, working with AccurateShooter.com. We're field testing a Gary Eliseo project gun this morning, first time out. This is round three, going to go through it shortly. Cleaning between every shot, breaking in a Krieger 12.5 to 1 stainless steel 5R barrel.
You say it's pretty smooth, Mark?
Extremely smooth. in factory barrels, you feel all kinds of rough patches and drag action on your patches. These are the first patches going through it. It's just glass smooth. Very nice feel.
Mark, what's involved in putting the gun together after you clean the bore?
It's really simple. It's a little bit more involved than a standard stocked gun, but the buttstock breaks off real easy with one pin release and a screw. Going back together, the bolt slides in. Stock goes on, depress the pin, lock it, thread it down, good to go. Okay, this is a mag feeder. And how are your ears, Paul? Do you want to touch this one off? Are you okay?
I'm good.
Here we go.